previous experiment which I have we have done is UJT characteristic, and we have understood the characteristic of a UJT which is unijunction transistor. Now in continuation with the same experiment, we are having one more part, that is UJT as a relaxation oscillator. So UJT is acting like an oscillator. What oscillator is doing? It's converting your DC signal into AC signal. So that is the basic purpose of an oscillator. So if you can see here, I have set up the entire thing. Okay. So here we are having this is our power DC source, which is around 9 volt. This is our circuit which I have connected. Here we are having a variable resistance, and this is our CRO. So this is our entire connection. And so you can look it here. So I have connected the circuit, and I have kept this value of R1 as around 1000, okay? And this is our 10 kilo ohm. So using this two combination, we will try to get the answers. So R will keep it something around whatever value which I will get from this combination, that will be your R. So here R1 I have taken it 1. So 1 plus 10, it will become 11. So 11K, okay, 11,000 ohm. So that will be our ohm resistance. And this is a time period which we can calculate with the help of formula. And this R and C, R we have got it from there. C is the capacitor, only one capacitor is in the circuit. That value we have kept it here. And eta we have calculated, we have got this value of eta in our previous experiment. So that eta I will put it here, you will get the value of time period. And then that time period from calculation and from observation, we will try to match it. So if you can see here, okay, so this is our connection. Actually, it has moved little more downward. Okay, so I have done this. Actually, it has moved a little bit. Okay, fine. You can see now. Now it's stable. So from this observation, you have to take x-axis. So from x-axis you can see it's around one complete is around 1.8 millisecond. So from the observation I will get 1.8 millisecond, and then we'll check the resistance value, whatever resistance value which we are having. Here I have removed around 5000 ohm, and this is 10,000, so 15,000 ohm. So you'll calculate it, and from calculation you will get the observed calculated value and from the observed value, and we will match it whether both are matching or not. So we'll almost get of the both the values. And this is a single signal generator. So this is a square and sine wave generator which is used to give the signal. So what can be done, if I give the signal to the CRO, and if I make it in XY mode, so both the signals, if they are matching with the frequency, you will get a different shape. So this also can be used to find the frequency. Okay, so it's the frequency of the oscillator. So frequency of the oscillator can be calculated using this. One is time-based method, other one is Lissajous figure. So we are doing with time-based method, and we are getting the value of the and expected value, and the value which we are calculated is matching. So this is giving us a relaxation oscillator. So this is our relaxation oscillator. Okay, so I think this is clear. This is our diagram, okay, connection, and this is our CRO. That's it.